Now we'll consider lateral canal BPPV. This should be suspected in a patient who presents with positional vertigo on bending down or turning over in bed. It is also strongly suspected when the Dick's hallpipe manoeuvre provokes a pure horizontal nystagmus. We're going to go on and start with the most common form, the type that's called geotropic lateral canal BPPV. In this, the mechanism is probably canalolithiasis. We describe first the diagnostic manoeuvre and then two types of therapeutic manoeuvre, the barbecue manoeuvre and then the Vannucci manoeuvre, which the patient can perform himself at home. We then describe the ageotropic lateral canal BPPV called cupulolithiasis. We describe the diagnostic manoeuvre and also a reverse Vannucci manoeuvre. And now we're going to look at the diagnostic manoeuvre and the therapeutic manoeuvre for a right lateral canal BPPV. We're going to ask the patient on this occasion to lie straight back. And then, if we look carefully at the eyes, we will see that the patient has a typical left beating nystagmus, which would indicate that the lateral canal BPPV is on the right. And slowly we'll find that the nystagmus dies away. Now we need to let the patient know that they're going to have to turn on the couch through to the right side. And here we can see now that the nystagmus reverses, becoming right beating. And associated with this, of course, is the world spinning. The nystagmus here is prolonged and much less paroxysmal than that of posterior canal BPPV. To check, it is necessary to do the manoeuvre on the other side. The head is turned completely towards the left, and typically the nystagmus reverses, becoming left beating and geotropic, i.e. canalolithiasis. This is a strong argument for lateral canal BPPV. Now we're going to go on and look at the barbecue therapeutic manoeuvre. We return to the normal supine position. From here, we can start the therapeutic manoeuvre. In fact, there are several variants of the manoeuvre, and we could start across on the lesion side itself. And here, the lady is turned towards the right with nystagmus beating towards her right. We wait for it to end, and then we're going to start the barbecue manoeuvre, which is a rollover towards her left-hand side. So we take her back into the supine position, and here we have left-beating nystagmus. And then we take her another 90 degrees over towards the left side. The left nystagmus continues. And then we turn her right over onto her front with her head facing downwards. She waits in this position for a good 2 or 3 minutes. And then we can complete the full 360 degree turn by asking her to roll right back over towards the left and lying on her right hand side, where she may wait a full 10 minutes. And then here we have the Vannucci therapeutic manoeuvre. This is an alternative manoeuvre to the barbecue manoeuvre and simply consists of asking the patient to sleep for several nights on their side, in this case on the left. According to results in the literature, this manoeuvre is just as effective as barbecue. And now we go on to talk about the diagnostic manoeuvre, cupulolithiasis. For this manoeuvre, the patient is seated on the couch and asked to keep their eyes open as they lay down on their back. She acknowledges straight away that she's spinning a bit. This particular condition is much less well recognised, but nonetheless accounts for a large proportion of cases with lateral canal BPPV. To start with, the patient is asked to turn their head to the right. As a consequence of this, they have left beating nystagmus in the opposite direction to head rotation. This is very likely to be cupulolithiasis of the lateral canal and is known as an ageotropic nystagmus. It is often paroxysmal and quite prolonged. It is often necessary to wait for up to 2 to 3 minutes for it to subside. As the nystagmus dies down, the patient starts to feel better. They are told at this point that they will need to turn completely over onto the other side towards the left. Okay, over she goes. Now, in this situation, of course, the nystagmus will reverse and become right beating, always ageotropic. The treatment of lateral canal cupulolithiasis has not been well characterized. In practice, we start by a Vannucci maneuver, which is reversed to try and transform the cupulolithiasis into a canalolithiasis. We ask the patient to sleep on the affected side, in this case on the right, for the next 2 nights. The aim is to encourage detachment of the otoliths from the cupula. In successful cases, it is then possible to use the therapeutic methods used for canalolithiasis.